U.S. Air Force Long Shot, Air-to-Air Combat Drone System. General Atomics Aeronautical Systems has revealed for the first time an artist's impression of a missile-carrying air-to-air combat drone that it is developing as part of the Defense Advanced Research Projects Agency's Long Shot program. General Atomics, as well as Lockheed Martin and Northrop Grumman, is working on this project, which calls for an unmanned aircraft that can be launched in midair from a manned aircraft before flying into potentially more hazardous environments and engaging aerial threats using its own missiles. General Atomics' website about small unmanned aircraft systems shows a stealthy-looking drone with a prominent chine around the center of its fuselage, the line tapering to meet a high-mounted fixed wing that apparently has only moderate sweep. There is a prominent V-shaped tail and we can see a weapons bay on the side of the rear fuselage, with two doors, but it's not clear if there's a symmetrical one on the opposite side. It's hard to gauge the size of General Atomics' Long Shot, although it's clearly big enough to accommodate radar-guided air-to-air missiles, including what appears to be an AIM-120 and future AIM-260 advanced long-range air-to-air missiles. With that in mind, it's notable that the Long Shot concept from DARPA and Northrop Grumman both showed what appeared to be new, smaller-sized dam designs. Various panels around the airframe could be meant to represent conformal antennas for onboard sensors, but it is hard to say for sure. However, both the General Atomics and Northrop Grumman Long Shot concepts depict drones that are much more aircraft-like than the DARPA artwork, which seems to have more in common with a cruise missile or remote carrier. General Atomics also provides more details about how the company expects the Long Shot to be employed in combat, describing a small system that will help clear the way through the skies, and that will charge into hostile airspace armed with its own air-to-air missiles, able to fire on enemy targets if it were so commanded. It could initiate a fighter sweep ahead of a strike wave without putting a human crew in danger, or it could join an attack alongside the Vanguard with human-crewed warplanes. All this certainly fits in with our understanding of the Long Shot thus far, as a means of extending the reach of the launch platform in aerial combat, while also reduce its vulnerability to hostile aircraft or air defenses. The DARPA mentions that Long Shot could be launched from either a manned aircraft or from a larger drone, and that one option would be for it to be carried by bombers, providing them with a potent new anti-air capability. While adding Long Shot to legacy bombers, such as the B-2 and upcoming B-21 Raider stealth bomber, and making it so that it can fit in its weapons bay, would also be very beneficial. The Air Force has already talked about its forthcoming B-21 as potentially having air-to-air capabilities, but exactly in what manner remains undisclosed. One option could be the use of a counter-air drone system like Long Shot. The Raider will have optionally manned capabilities, which could also be leveraged if it were to be employed as a possible Long Shot launch platform. How the Long Shot will actually cue its missiles onto a target remains unclear, but it's highly probable that data links would provide targeting data, either supplied from the launch aircraft, drone, or from a wide variety of sensor-equipped platforms. All in all, Long Shot seems to offer a variety of options to enhance the air combat capabilities of manned and unmanned teaming alike, potentially with a comparatively low price tag, although so far we don't know to what degree it's expected to be attritable, or if, like some of General Atomics' other SWAS concepts, it's actually expected to be recovered and reused. Thank you for watching. Please like, share, comment, and subscribe.